yeah, what's going on YouTube? TV back here. Today, I am bringing you my competitive class setups for the respawn game types in Advanced Warfare, just like I promised yesterday in my vlog. So, let's get right into it. It's pretty straightforward. I'm just going to say a little disclaimer real quick. This is the first couple of weeks of the game. All this stuff might change the more I get, you know, time on the game. We've been playing quite a bit. I'm just going to show you guys the classes that have been working out a little bit better than others for me throughout scrims and tournaments, etc. The ones that I've been having the most success with individually. These are catered to the sort of role I'm playing on my team right now. I'm sort of like our secondary hill player, just sort of a support player, filling in gaps overall throughout the map, trying to slay and get points on the board as best I can for this squad. So overall, it's pretty straightforward. Until the Bal gets nerfed, you just have to use a Bal. All the classes have the Bal, and it's just the way it needs to be. Got lightweight, fast hands, toughness, blast suppressor on this class. With overclock and double semtex. I'm really enjoying the fast hands double semtex. I think it's a little bit overpowered from what I've seen and used so far. I think it needs to be taken away or maybe banned, but I mean, it's not too overpowered, I guess, but it's too easy to use in my opinion. It's very easy to hold off a cut or hold off a hard point just by popping two semtexes and even breaking heals. You can just pop in two semtexes very, very quickly, just tap an RB and have a very good shot at getting a kill if they don't have trophy system on and make them move throughout the hills. So overall, this is what I'm using so far. I use switch between overclock and trophy system on this class, depending on what the other teams are using. If I'm getting pelted by stuns on rotations and getting hit with a bunch of semtexes in hill, I'll pop this on to make sure I block at least two of them before getting taken out, hopefully taking people with me. Moving on to my next class, this third one. It changes up a little bit. I take off fast hands, put on the perk 1 greed with overcharge, and I have overclock. This is my fast rotation class. Overcharged with overclock means I can run very fast, be on rotation very quickly, and then I have a semtex on this for the rotation as well. It's a very situational class. I'll pull it out if we need to make a rotation. If we're rotating a little bit early from a hill and I'm like one of the point people, I want to make sure I have this class out so I can get there way before the other team. If they're using a class like this, their overclock ability is going to run out a little bit more quickly than mine because I have overcharged on and I can get there much more quickly and just have that overall speed advantage. I have a backup red dot class here as well. Sometimes the iron sights just don't work out depending on some connections, so sometimes I need to pull out the red dot sight. But overall, I haven't really pulled this class out in the past couple of days because I've been having a lot more success with the iron sights, at least online. Maybe that'll change on land, but you never know. I'm just sticking with the ones that I've been doing the best with so far. Then my last class, this is what you're going to see me using pretty much all the time on CTF and uplink. I'm using a stun grenade with overcharge and overclock. I run a lot of flags on CTF between me and Embos. We're usually one getting behind them and getting that flag pull out and making some crazy moves. So I love having the overclock with overcharge, being able to, you know, make a quick getaway and juke around the map with accelerated speed. And then having a stun, I feel like stuns are very, very, very strong in this game purely because you can self-detonate whenever you want. So you can shoot them basically however far you want and then detonate them whenever. And they're just great. They completely mess up the other team if you connect with them, slowing them down tremendously. And I feel like it is a must for CTF. If you aren't using these, you should probably start using them because that's just how good they are. Pretty straightforward classes for you guys. I'm sort of leaning away from S&D right now. I'm waiting till I get more experience. They're basically similar to these classes. Maybe I'll swap out frags or keep the semtexes for zoning out enemies. And I'll swap out the exo ability for the exo mute instead of the trophy or overclock. But still, sound whoring doesn't seem too bad this far in the game with S&D. So maybe I'll keep on an overclock class, very, very similar to this, so I can, you know, pull up that bomb a little bit quicker when I'm planting, etc. It's useful to have all types of classes. So maybe I'll make another video explaining my classes for S&D a little bit more in depth. I just want to stick to this video being about my respawn ones. Hopefully these classes help you guys out a little bit. They're very, very basic and straightforward. It's just how the game is right now. It's just the best way to go, having lightweight, having that speed, having, you know, being able to shoot a bunch of crap at the enemies holding hills, and then being able to slow them down and still having that speed in CTF as well. pretty straightforward because everyone is using the Bow. The SMGs are just not really worth using at this point in the game. Hopefully that changes soon. I'd like to see a little bit of a differentiation with the gun usage throughout this game. Hopefully the KF5 becomes able to be used because I love using that shit. But right now it's just way too damn weak. We'll see in the next couple of months to come. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Short and sweet, explaining my very basic classes with the Bow. Balance is always the best. Hopefully you guys learned something from this video. Let me know if you like my classes in the comments below, or let me know if you hate them. That's fine too. Whatever. Sub to my channel. Follow my live stream, MLG.TV. Content, videos, streaming pretty much every day, so make sure you tune in and don't miss a thing. Appreciate you guys watching this video if you watch the whole thing through. New content coming out pretty much every day. Sub to the channel. Follow me on MLG.TV. Love you guys. Hope you have a good one. Have a good one. Later.